Dear brothers and sisters, from the first to the last page of his Gospel, Mark shows us clearly that the purpose of Jesus' mission is, so to speak, to open heaven on earth. Heaven understood as the world of God, God himself. In other words, Jesus comes into this world because men, women, children of Adam and Eve, middle earth, may experience in some way heaven. We experience God. Jesus, true God and true man, is the door through which heaven makes himself present on earth, a world, that of God, a, so to speak, universe, the heavenly one, in which the rules that apply to the earth are non-valid. In fact, the laws that regulate the world of God, which Jesus reveals to us, are so counterintuitive that they leave us, to say the least, perplexed, disconcerted. However, Jesus asks his disciples to accept them and live them by making an act of trust, of faith in him, splendor of truth. In fact, Jesus is never wrong, cannot deceive us. If then, dear brothers and sisters, in following Jesus, we have the incredible experience of feeling be rising up as on eagle wings and experience the exaltation of climbing the peaks of the Spirit to the extent that we descend from the pedestal of our ego and humble ourselves in the abyss of our nothingness, we should not be surprised. That's how it works in God's world. In order to go up, we must go down. If we perceive the thrill of victory when we lose our life for love, and experience endless happiness when forgetting ourselves, we make others happy, we should not be surprised. That's how it works in God's world. In order to win, we must lose. If we feel in our hearts bursting life without limits, when we deny ourselves and are able, like Jesus, to love always, to love everyone, especially our enemies, to love up to the madness of the cross, we should not be surprised. That's how it works in God's world. In order to rise again, we must die. We should not be surprised, dear friends, if, as we will listen in the passage of the Gospel of next Sunday, September 23rd, to be first, we must be the last. All of these things seem incredible. The real struggle to understand how to be first. We must be the servants of all. And yet, what a primacy of excellence we will be conferred by the Lord himself. When at the end of life, we will be told, come, blessed of my Father, you have put into practice my greatest power of love, given to you in the baptism through the Holy Spirit. With that power, you serve everybody, giving life above all to the poorest, the neediest, the rejected from the society. Come then and rejoice and exult, therefore, in the participation to the endless party in the eternal kingdom, my Father. Dear brothers and sisters, it's all for now. Ciao. God bless you always.